What's going on, everyone? In this video, I'll be showing you how to install Kodi on your Apple TV with or without a USB Type-C cable. This tutorial works on the fourth generation Apple TV and the newly released 4K Apple TV. It's essentially the same tutorial as my previous one, but I figured this might be easier for new users to follow. First thing is obvious, you will need an Apple computer running the latest version of xcode. You can download that from the Mac App Store. You will then need to download iOS App Signer in the description and the latest Kodi dev file also linked in the description. So go ahead and open up xcode. Before you do anything, go over to xcode, then preferences, click on the accounts tab, and you want to go ahead and add in your Apple ID. Now remember, with your free Apple ID, this will only work for 7 days, and then you will need to re-sign the app. You will see more about that later. If you have a developer account, you will be able to sign the app for a whole year. All right, so there's that. Go ahead and close that. Open xcode once again, and now you want to go and click on create a new xcode project. Make sure tvOS is checked, single view app is checked, and click next. You want to type a product name such as Kodi, and we're going to leave team none for now. You will see why later, and we're going to leave everything else default. Make sure create git repository is checked and click create. I usually save everything to the download folder for easy finding. So as you can tell, you're gonna get an error message. So just go over to team and click your Apple ID. You may also get another error message, and I'll show you how to fix that. So this is the other message I encountered: failed to create provisioning profile. So what I did to fix this was go over to bundle identifier and change that to com.lbtechtips.kodi17. You can of course change LB Tech Tips to your own name. Just make sure it's something unique so you won't have any problems. Click on try again and wait for it to repair. All right, once you are done, everything is good to go. You can go ahead and open the iOS App Signer, and where it says input file, you can drag and drop your dev file. Where you see provisioning profile, just select what we just created a few seconds ago. From here, you can see earlier I'd use my name, and then later on I use LB Tech Tips. I'm gonna go ahead and choose LB Tech Tips because it's the latest one. The other one was just try everything before I actually made this tutorial. So after you click that, click on start and find a location to save the file to. You can go ahead and rename it to something easier like Kodi ATV for Apple TV and click on save. And then you just let that run for a few seconds. Here you just select always allow, or you can just allow it one time, it's up to you. When you get done, you can close out of iOS App Signer. Now if you are using the USB Type-C cable, just plug it in at this point. And once you plug it in, click here where I did and select your Apple TV. Next, go to Window, Devices and Simulators, and you will see your Apple TV right there. You can go ahead and click the plus icon and locate the IPA file we created with the iOS App Signer. Click on it and then click open. I'm going to go ahead and cancel that because this next part is for those without the USB Type-C cable. So you basically do this wirelessly. Make sure both devices are connected to the same Wi-Fi. Then go into your settings, remotes and devices, then remote app and devices, and wait here a few seconds. On your xcode, go to devices and simulators, and you will see there pair with Apple TV. You will get a code on your Apple TV, which you will need to type in to xcode. This code only works for a single use, so my code will not work for you guys. If you get any errors trying to pair, just unpair the device and try it again. Next, click the plus icon again, just like earlier. Locate your Kodi IPA file, click open, and now wait until it has finished installing. This takes quite a while if you are doing it wirelessly, so just go grab a coffee and come back. After you have done that on both devices, you should see Kodi under installed apps. At this point, you can go ahead, go to your device, and launch Kodi. It should be working, and you can go ahead and install any add-ons you would like. Now remember, once again, with the free Apple ID, you only get this app for 7 days and then it stops working. You will need to follow this tutorial again in order to get it for another 7 days. You can also sign up for a developer account, which is $100 a year, and you will then have the app for one whole year, and then you can re-sign it again. That is pretty much it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. Hit the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos like this, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next video.